All right, Shalom. First, I want to give all praises, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Bahashem Yahweh Shai, Bahashem Rachakudash. Double honors to the apostles of Great Millstone, and peace and blessings to the elect. Back in with another article. Okay, this was published June 22nd, which was today. Okay, and it says here, firing even one bullet at Iran will set fire to U.S. and allies, Iranian general warns. All right, it says Washington and its allies will pay dearly for any act of aggression against Tehran, an Iranian general has said, vowing to retaliate with overwhelming force if the U.S. dares to even fire one bullet at the Islamic Republic. Okay, and all right, and you can see that these Iranians, they're not playing, because they're not stupid and they're not scared. All right, and they've seen what the U.S. has done to other nations in the past, similar to the situation that they're in now. Okay, it says firing one bullet toward Iran will set fire to the interests of America and its allies in the Middle East. Armed Forces General Staff Spokesman Brigadier General Abolfaz, what kind of name? Shekarchi. If I'm saying that right, told Tasnim News Agency on Saturday, the Islamic Republic has never and will never start any wars. We'll just call him Sheikh, all right? Sheikh added, stressing that if the enemy commits the smallest of mistakes, it will face the biggest revolutionary reaction from Iran in Central and West Asia, and it will certainly not survive the battle. Well, that's biblical, okay? Because according to the according to biblical prophecy, America, all right, or the U.S. will be destroyed in this world war. Now, you have other parts which also will be hit, all right? Other parts of the world will be hit with the missiles. But the U.S., America, Babylon, is going to be completely destroyed, all right? So, yeah, it will not survive the battle, okay? But it's showing you the spirit that Iran is in, all right? Because the scriptures talk about how when you start seeing Iran and the U.S. go at it, know that we're very close, all right? Because they are key players within this Third World War, all right? To draw in Russia and all China and all these other countries, all right? But Iran is basically like the center. So it says, if the enemy fires one shot in our direction, we will fire 10 back, okay? So they, like it says, they're vowing an overwhelming reaction, okay? Biggest revolutionary reaction from Iran, all right? And that's war talk, okay? That's war talk. That's them telling them, listen, man, you play games with us, we're done, because they're already sanctioning them. They're already ruining Iran's economy, all right? And Iran is at the point where they're like, yo, we're tired of this, man. We're, like they said, they don't go on the offensive, okay? But when it comes to defense, yeah, they will defend themselves. That's why Iran hasn't done anything, all right, to provoke the U.S., okay? But the U.S., which is the one provoking Iran is only acting in reaction to the U.S.'s actions, all right? It says the general's warning comes days after Iran shot down U.S. military drone, which Tehran claims had been flying in its airspace. U.S. President Donald Trump wrote in a tweet on Friday that with just minutes before execution, he aborted an airstrike against three sites in Iran after learning that an estimated 150 Iranians would die as a result of the attacks. As though he cared, as though he cares if 150 Iranians die, man. All right. Ultimately, you know, through the spirit, it's not time. All right, because that would have just set off the full on war. All right, but it's not. It ain't about this, man. Okay, there's still other prophecies that need to take place. All right, before this Third World War. Okay. But guess what? It's still gonna happen. Okay, this is inevitable. Okay, these nations will go to war because the tensions at which they have reached now, it's not going to cool down and it's not going to go in reverse. It's too late for that. They've already broken too many deals, done away with too many treaties, all right, to then go back with that. The trust, all right, to be able to have a treaty between these two nations has been broken. It has been destroyed. Okay, and they're in that mode of war. Okay, they're tired of the US's BS, and they're like, you know what? That no more talks, man. Now it's time for action. It says U.S. President Donald Trump has struggled to garner support for his administration's hardline policy towards Iran after unilaterally withdrawing from the 2015 International Nuclear Accord and reimposing sanctions on Iran, which Trump said on Monday he's going to add more sanctions. It says amid increasing hostility between Washington and Tehran, Britain's Minister of State of the Middle East, Andrew Murison, is set to visit the Islamic Republic on Sunday for talks. See? Talks. They don't want to talk. Okay? At this time of increased regional tensions and at a crucial period for the future of the nuclear deal, this visit is an opportunity to further open frank and constructive engagement with the government of Iran, the UK foreign minister said in a statement. All right, they can do as much talk that they want, but the prophecy will not be broken. Something is going to happen, and regardless of what they try to do, hey, that war is going to happen, okay? So let's keep that in mind and keep watching these signs and these prophecies, man, because this is all you hear about in the news nowadays. But what do you have our people doing? What do you have Jake doing? All right, you Israelites out here just literally, oh, it's summertime, right? So all you see is they come out, they set up their chairs, their little barbecues, the loud, stupid music, and that's all they do. Open up fire hydrants and just, you know, run around in the streets and, you know, that. What, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, what are you doing to prepare for what's about to happen? Nothing. They don't even care. They live their life carefree as though America or their life, like, civilization as it is now is going to carry on forever. Listen, man, when they set the martial law troops loose, they're going to have a field day with you, Jakes, man. You so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, man, they're going to rip you limb from limb. You are in no shape. You are not prepared mentally, physically, or spiritually. A lot of you are going to be screwed, man. You know, these girls like to dress revealing themselves provocatively. Guess what, man? Them troops are also men. Okay? They'll rape these women. They will kill you. They will send you to FEMA camps, rip out your hair, torture you, all these different things they're going to do. But is that what our people are worried about? Nope. They could care less. You know, they live in that good life, right? They're living my best life. Yeah, that's what they like to, that's the spirit they like to be in, right? Well, that's why it says in 1 Thessalonians 5:3, when they shall see peace and safety. Oh, summertime, you know, summertime, fine. Let me come out here and chill real quick. Then sudden destruction cometh upon them, man. And a lot of you Israelites are not going to be expecting it. All right, it's going to come like a thief in the night, and it's gonna get you, man. Ain't no escaping it, okay? Lord willing, this was edifying unto the elect. Kol ha'loi, ha'o ba'ashim, ya'o shai, and shalom.